Hi everyone, Tazzy T here. I'm down back in that creek again and I brought Curly Sue with me. I'm learning him how to pan. He's been itching to have a go for a while, so I've showed him where to dig and he's at it. We'll see what he gets with his first pan. I'm reckoning he'll get a saw back and maybe some nuggets.
Yeah, he's got the twin peaks.
Bloody ripper.
That's it, mate. Take that shit away. That's
awesome. Another trick you can do too when you first learn how to pan is do two or three washes. You know your gold's going to be down the bottom. Tip it on side and scrap the top third of it off with the back of your hand. Because now there's nothing in it.
Yeah.
I didn't show him that trick.
Still works.
So as you get into that last little bit, when you're rocking it back and forth like that, keep rocking it and tip it forward. And that'll concentrate it all on that bottom ripple, tipping forward a bit more. Right, slow him down. Right, dunk it and wash it. That's it. Should be able to wash most of that material off. And then squish him back and see what you got. That's it. Tip him back a little bit further. Keep washing it. Down. That's it. There we go. The quill, not so much. You've caught the black sands though. So that's a win. Do you want me to finish that pan for you now?
Yeah.
Yep. Let's see what's in. Real fine fucking gold in there at the top. Real fine stuff. Hard to see in this light.
Mm.
Plenty of it though, lots of little specks. Beautiful blue sky day today. And we're in the creek. And we're finding a bit of gold. Little bits of dust. Jake's on his second pan. Any ounce nuggets, mate? That's 51 shades of fuck all.
How do you
know? I don't, I'm guessing. Old Sluicy's over here working.
Lucy the Sluicy.
She's still cleaning herself out. I'm pretty happy with how that's working. I haven't actually explored further down this creek yet because I've been pressed for time, but must come back and give it a second try. Jack's been digging out some on the back of this big boulder. But it's surprisingly deep. I put my foot in just there, and yeah, it's well over my gumboot, so. Awesome spot.
these little holes here.
There's holes here everywhere.
Now there are the bandicoots down here looking for grubs. Chances are they're little lobsters. And you used to be able to catch them and eat them, and people caught them and ate them like they were going out of fashion, and they decimated the population. So about 20 years ago they banned it. Consequently, the numbers are coming back, and you see them. You very rarely see them in a creek, though. Generally, I find them walking across the road, which is bizarre, but they travel, so, yeah. An awesome place.
This is what we call laying down on the job. All for the want of a longer shovel.
Get in there, Jake, go!
Plenty of black sands in that, though. You can see it. Another garnet.
No. Garnet.
Now while you're doing that, dunk it in the water and keep doing that. That's it. Exactly like that. And as you're doing it, rock it forward a little bit and keep doing it. Forward towards the ripples. So you might want to spin your pan around so your ripples are pointing away from you there, huh? Right, pull him out, pour the water off, and keep it at that angle and dunk it up and down. See the wave come in, wash material out. That's it. Do that five times, shake it five times. Alright. Well, either that's a slurry, that material is going to be dropping. That's it. That's enough, tipping forward, wash it off. And just like that, we have another prospector. Unreal. No, we just went for a walk further down the creek to have a look. It's got little waterfalls, so I'll go back and film them for you one day. Much of the same, there's no real bedrock intrusion, so it's pretty much just an alluvial deposit. So, want to try some of the cracks in amongst the boulders and that, and we'll test them one day. Well, I've just done a few more pans. Three or four specks, just specks, in every pan. I've dug off the top, I've dug off the bottom, I've dug a bit out of the bank, just having a, you know, random sample. Yeah. So these bits are, you know, they're dots. But they're there. I'll give them that. And it's in every pan, so. There's a bit of silver here too. Well, what an unexpected place. Honestly, I didn't expect to even find the place, let alone get a nugget or two. Well, not nuggets, it's dust, but I mean, it's still gold. I'm happy as hell with that. And it's really close to home. And it's a pretty little spot. Just coming onto that time of year where the snakes are going to start getting out. That's always fun. I dare say that this is a patch of bush that's got farmland either side of it, so it's going to have snakes in here aplenty. So something to keep your eye out for. What an amazing place. Not a breath of wind down in here, a little bit of a valley. Big black woods about, big myrtle. Yeah, what a spot. So stoked I came and looked. So if you're a Tasmanian and you've got access to a computer, most people do, jump on the MRT website. Bring up their mineral deposits map viewer and have a good look. There's all sorts of different locations. Some you can get to, some you can't. Some are on private land, some are on places that have got, you know, big piles of blackberry that's just impossible to get through. Thanks for watching. Cheers.